Hey guys, Ronnie here with my week 37 pregnancy update, which is actually a baby update. For those that don't know, most of you do know, but I know there's a few people that only follow the videos, so you may have no idea. I'm a little late with this video because I was doing my pregnancy updates on Monday and it is Wednesday, but that is because this past Thursday, St. Patty's Day, my water broke early at 36 weeks and 4 days. So it was a little, I mean, I was joking that I wanted to come, you know, that I wanted the baby to come early and that I didn't think I'd make it out of March, but that was slightly too early for my taste. So I was a little worried that it was really early, and it was a little early. They held him in the NICU for a little bit to observe his respiratory. You know, and he's been having, you know, at the beginning he didn't have the natural, like, rooting, instinct that my first had to nurse. So he's only 5 pounds and 8 ounces. My first was 8'6". So, he's on the tiny side and he's right here in the bassinet. It's pretty much time for him to get up and eat. So I thought this would be a really good time to do a quick video. And I'll show him off, because I have to wake him up to eat anyway. So, although he's stirring, so you can tell it's time. But, you know, it went really, really well, and I wanted to kind of come on and tell the story really quick. It was 3:30 in the morning on St. Patrick's Day, and I woke up to go to the bathroom, as per my normal 3-time bathroom breaks a night. And when I came back to bed, there was a trickle of water. And I thought, oh my gosh, I think my water just broke. And I had no idea what it felt like because I didn't have, my water didn't break with my first, I was induced. So they actually had to rupture the water at the hospital. And that was a big, huge gush. And this was more kind of like this consistent trickle. And I thought, maybe I'm peeing my pants, but I just peed. So I doubt it. So I woke up the husband, who did the classic husband, like, wait, what, huh? What's going on? kind of thing. And I said, don't worry. I think it broke. You know, I'll call the hospital, but I'm not in a big rush because everything that I've read said that normally your body will go into labor within 24 hours of your water breaking. And that actually going to the hospital opens you up to even more infection because the first thing that they're going to do is an internal exam, and then that can introduce bacteria. And that's really the major concern when your water breaks early is that there's nothing protecting the baby from, you know, from infection and bacteria. So people are making fun of me, but I wasn't in a big rush because I wasn't having contractions yet. And I knew that the baby just wasn't going to pop out without, you know, some serious contractions happening at a steady pace. So I called the doctors, although they never called me back, which is a story in and of itself. And I fell back to sleep. Just for a few hours, and then I got the kindergartner on the bus. I called my mom. I called some friends, and I, you know, then I called the doctor. You know, of course, I said they want you to come in, which I knew they would. And so I packed my bag. I put the corned beef in the crock pot, which everybody was laughing at me. And I thought, well, people will have something to eat because I know that they were going to come in anyway. So I figured they'd have something to eat. So I kind of just did my normal morning routine, and then the husband and I headed to the hospital, and when they admitted me in triage, they verified that my water really did rupture, and they admitted me, and they started a Pitocin drip, which I wasn't too happy about because I really didn't want to be induced again. But I immediately made my intents known with the hospital. I said that first of all, I really wanted the ability to walk around. I didn't do that with baby number one. I kind of was chained to the bed as soon as they started the Pitocin syrup. And, you know, I think it was like 15 hours or something. And I was like, you know what? I've been really active this pregnancy. I really, really would like to walk around if possible. And it was kind of a funny reaction on the part of the hospital. They were like, oh, she wants to walk. You know, this was great. Like, they thought it was a good idea. Most of them, some of them, even the one OB was a little like, oh, you know, we'd rather, and I just was really, I'm a little older now, so it's easier for me to kind of make my intent known. So they scrambled to find a remote baby monitor, and they said as long as the, you know, the baby's monitored and they can hear the heartbeat and all that stuff, that they were fine with it. So they got, it took them about 10 minutes to find it. I guess not very many people walk around in the hospital. So they found it and they hooked it up to me. And I think I was admitted at like 11, 15 or something like that. Maybe noonish, somewhere around noon. And so I was in my room, say, around noon, and I was already kind of doing laps around. I had a large room. It wasn't a very busy baby day. And I started doing laps. I did a few laps around the floor, although the monitor would cut out, so I started to stay a little closer to the room. And I just kept walking, just a stroll. And I really, really think they made a huge difference. Maybe not so much in, you know, I don't know how much difference it made in labor, that kind of stuff, but for my mental sanity of not just laying in the bed for 7 hours, it made a huge difference. I was able to go to the bathroom when I wanted. I didn't have to call the nurse to unhook the monitors. I didn't have to, you know what I mean? So I had to carry the IV around with the Pitocin. So really similar to my first, the Pitocin didn't really take for a long time. So contractions just weren't really happening, and they kept upping it and upping it and upping it and upping it every 10 to 15 minutes. And then I want to say maybe around 6 p.m., I started to have some fairly consistent contractions, and I was 5 centimeters. And then they, let's think, from that point on, it happened so fast. I did get the epidural, but it only worked on one side, which again is another story in of itself. So I had really only left side labor pains, which was really weird sensation. My right leg was completely numb, and my left leg was only partially, and so I was able to feel pretty much everything on my left side only, which was really strange. But once contractions came, they came at a regular clip, and it wasn't like your normal, it was really, really fast. The husband's getting out of the shower, so I have to wrap this up. Anyway, so then at that point, they said, okay, it's time to push. Like, the baby was really, really in the ordering the birth canal. And one push. I don't know if it was second child. He was so tiny. I don't know. But literally, I felt him come out, and they put him on my belly, and it was awesome. And we had him in the room for quite some time. And I did get him to latch. I am really adamant about nursing, and so he has been breastfeeding really well. Getting better and better with every session, and we're on a regular schedule now. But it was fabulous. And if I keep talking about it, I'll probably start to cry. So I'm going to wrap this up. But I'll show him really, really fast, okay? I don't know why I'm starting to whisper. Yeah, he's starting to stir because it's time to eat. Hey, buddy. Everybody wants to see you, okay? Open your door. Oh, he's doing a little yawn thingy for his. My 37-week pregnancy update. He's doing really well. His hat's coming off. Let's take your hat off for a second. He's kind of in preemie clothes, so we don't have a lot of clothes that fit him, but my friend brought over some preemie clothes for us, and they're perfect. And you'll see he's rooting. He's rooting on his clothes. Yeah. So it's time for us to eat, and I'm going to go. Thanks for keeping up with me, and I'll talk to you soon.